Now, colleagues, I think this has been wonderful, certainly for me. I would like to start by expressing sincere thanks to various individuals and organizations, because we are the Alliance because of what many people and organizations have been to us. And that, in a sense, echoes the spirit of Ubuntu, I am because we are, and the spirit of our commitment as the Alliance. The International Development Research Center of Canada, a fostering research and education network in Africa, actually funded by the Andrew Mellon Foundation through TENET South Africa, the Open Society Institute of South Africa, Cisco Systems. Cisco Systems donated our first router, which we proudly placed in the Dante Cage in London, and the European Union. These have been very supportive. We are now able to meet most of our costs as the Alliance, but I tell you, 4 or 5 years ago, it was not possible. And even our development costs for the network require ongoing support, and support of various organizations is therefore appreciated. And then in a different capacity about GIANT, GIANT, the European network, has been wonderful. We have been working with the NREM Policy Committee, establishing peering points, establishing interconnections, and getting international transit at no cost to the Alliance. And really, that is something to be thankful for. So through our colleagues here from Europe, you are the owners of GIANT and the NREM. We do thank you very much. And then, of course, Dante, which manages GIANT, has also been extremely supportive. We must thank our guests of honor. I think we really had to. We had the Honorable Minister of Education of Kenya, even if she could not come. She suitably delegated to a lady, thank God. We are normally short of ladies in these audiences. And then Permanent Secretary Dr. Bitang Endemo. I think we got a lot of inspirational remarks from them. It was not simply the routine guest of honor, go and say what you're supposed to say. I think they left a message for us to learn from. The entrants from outside, I will not list them again, but your presence here is appreciated. You give us encouragement. Internet, who has left, Louis is still here, but you have come in your different individual capacities because you feel that you have got a need, and you are part of that need. And I believe in coming here, I recognize that our strength is also your strength. Just like the spirit of the Alliance says, if one region is weak, the other region cannot be strong. So I think somebody said this morning, I believe it was Bruce, that we must be able to work with each other, sacrifice a bit of autonomy, whether you're from Europe or from Africa, so that the community of researchers can then really grow as a community. Not simply for the sake of the community, but for the development of our people. At the end of the day, we are the Alliance, not because we simply want to connect and research. We do that so that we can create a difference to the majority of people in our continent, who, as we all know, live below the poverty line. I always tell people who come to Nairobi and Kampala that, you know, the people you meet in these big cities are barely 5 to 10% of the population. And those people like Nyoli and I, people who are advantaged and live in better conditions. The majority in Nairobi live in Basare, in Kibera, the slums. If you come to Kampala, forget about Nairobi Conference Center. They live in Chimkuru, they live in all the slums. And we have got an obligation as people who are educated at a public expense in our countries to ensure that those people get a chance in life. Our commercial partners, really, this conference has run very well, partly because of our commercial partners. The sponsorship they have given has been tremendous. They start seeing value on both sides, and that is appreciated. Kenneth, I think Kenneth has done a wonderful job, and you really personally. You have got a team under you, but a team without a leader is not a team. And therefore, I recognize Maureen and the rest of them. We know that your leadership has been crucial in this, and that is appreciated. And senior on the Alliance side, Margaret, you have had your team, and you have led them very well. So between the two of you, we appreciate the work you have done for this conference. It is what it is because you have done what you have done. We had more than 25 abstracts, was it, started, Margaret? We had about 3 times the number of abstracts that we could accommodate, and therefore, we left out some good papers that should have been here. So also, as President and Absent, your efforts are appreciated. It has been interesting to see the evolution of these conferences, those who were there from the first one, from simple events, and I was sitting back then listening to the quality of some of the papers from the African authors and from colleagues from outside, and I said, yes, something is actually happening here, something to be proud of. So thank you very much to authors. Session chairs, you have destroyed the myth that in Africa we don't give time. Session chairs, thank you for that, because I really hate it sometimes when people come here and ask, they say no. Here, when they set an o'clock, they mean 11 o'clock. Let's realize we are talking about gigabits per second. We are talking about microseconds and nanoseconds. That is our language in this community. And that's a minute becomes very precious. So think about, if we lose a minute, how much data transfer have we lost on a 10 gigabit circuit? That makes you sit back and boast. So those are my thanks to everybody. But permit me some reflections as we end this conference. Some of us are really excited now. We have been at the heart of change in terms of seeing the changes in this African continent. I remember the times, and some of you remember the times, when working with the computers was using a card punching machine. How many of you remember this? I know my chairman. Professor Kazamira, by the way, Professor Kazamira forced me to take this session. He refused. He said, this time I'm delegating to you. Thank you for that, Professor Kazamira. But we have seen those days. We have been proud of having something. I remember my first upgrade from an 8 kilobit processor to a computer which could handle 16 kilobits. I was proud of it. I talked to everybody. And then storage. We used audio storage, the audio cassettes, which young people don't even know, running in an audio drive, and you do the programming. When I got my first hard drive, I was excited. It was a whopping 32 megabytes. Now, we've seen those times. I've come to a time when we can talk about gigabits of capacity coming to Africa. It's something really wonderful. We've been fighting regulation and policy because I was again lucky to be involved in efforts to try and change the regulatory environment in our continent. I was a regulator at some point of my life, and that we set up a capacity building network, which still exists, covering Eastern, Southern, and Western Africa, simply telling policymakers and regulators that prices are high because policy is bad and because regulation is bad. Those things are changing. When we had Dr. Tang and them talking yesterday, if only half of our permanent secretaries could talk like that, Africa would be different. Why does it cost, and this came up several times, why does it cost 60% of your cost on the local loop, which is about a tenth of the actual cost? Really, it doesn't make any sense. Two simple things, policy and regulation. And that's why it has been pushed as immigrants. And we are excited that, yes, we are now getting something for ourselves. Let's not forget, and John Walwego made this point very clearly, Yoli could be sitting on gigabits, but the people around you are still sitting on kilobits because they are subject to the masses, not only of the commercial sector, it's not their fault. They are subject to the masses of our own governments. Our governments are causing the high prices in this continent. And until they realize that things are not going to change, it's not sufficient that they change for you and I. It is important that they change for everybody. And again, I've been reflecting on the alliance from very humble beginnings. I talked about those five people, six people, who dare to go out and register an organization. And you now have a conference of this size, which has got international interest, where Africa is making a statement that we exist, we are part of the research and education community, we are part of the UCAM so that we can work together for the betterment of the world. I think for the Alliance and the NN, this is a proud moment. So this is early days yet. There will be times when we are going to start breaking parallel sessions, because one session is no longer going to be enough. And I believe that in Dar es Salaam next year, it's more than likely that we're going to have a 3-day conference, not a 2-day conference, so that we can devote a full day to a scientific conference which brings on board the content side of our networks. And therefore, as we end today, I must thank all of you for coming. It is a proud moment for all of us in Africa. We believe this is just a start and that the sky is still the limit. Quote somebody, I forget the name, from South Africa, was causing a lot of commotion recently. The future is so bright, we need dark glasses. Thank you for coming. And please, let me give us for today. Oh yes, Professor Kazama gave me the right to say, I now declare this conference closed. Thank you.
Yes, most of what I was to say has been said. And as you know, with ICT people, especially those who came from the Unix world, you are not superfluous. They say that no news is good news in Unix. But I'll say a little bit of thanks to those who contributed to the success of this function on behalf of Kenneth. I believe all of us have learned something new. We've increased in our knowledge. I personally have learned about new things, new vocabulary, IT vocabulary. I never knew what are aglets. I've learned something new. I only knew about Java applets. Now they're aglets and other things. We also learned of something from the Czech Republic. I don't know what they were called, point nets for, I don't know, communication in fiber. But for the vote of thanks, I would say that we'd like to thank the organizing committee for making this a success, all the presenters for the time you took to prepare your papers, your real well research, and we enjoyed, even though some of the topics were not in our line of use, but we enjoyed your thoroughness in what you did. And we'd like to thank also the Ubuntu Net Alliance Secretariat and the Kenneth Secretariat for what they did. They did very many things to make this a success. We appreciate all the sponsors. I'll try to list some of them. If I miss out your name by mistake, it's not by intention. And we'll start with Lantech. We appreciate Lantech. We appreciate Soliton, Frontier Optical Networks, Sight and Sound. We appreciate Cisco, Safaricom, Jamie Telecom, and WIOC. They were just telling me how they pronounce the acronym. That is the WIOCC, WIOC. And we also appreciate, I mentioned later, Alcatel and Jomo Kenyatta University for all the work they did. We also come and we'd like to appreciate Africa Connect and our EU partners who have just been mentioned by Professor Tusu. We'd like to appreciate the CHAIN team and all the researchers who came and presented papers here. And we'd like to appreciate the Safari Park Hotel itself for hosting us, for BCD's travel, who organized the travel for all the participants who required travel, I believe most of them. And then the Kenya ICT board for their input, their sponsorship. And there's one person called Kaburu Kobia for the conference logo and for organizing the call for sponsorships. And then we'd also like to appreciate the management board members and everyone else who took part. And also you yourselves for coming, because if you did not come, then with all these arrangements, there would have been no conference. So we also want to appreciate you. Most of the time I would see this place was full house. So I was saying, wow, this is really good attendance. I said the response was very good. I don't know whether it's 80%, 90% of all those who were called, but I think it looked good. So I thank everyone for making this a success. And I also want to thank for those who believe, I'm among those who believe, you may not be among those who believe, but for those who believe, I want to thank the Almighty for giving us the breath of life. So I'd like us to appreciate all those people who have made this a success.